Hello students, welcome to my channel. For this session 21-22 CBSE has released the question paper with the marking scheme for term 1. These papers are based on latest exam pattern, and this is very important for preparation of upcoming CBSE 12th board exam 21-22 session. There are three sections: section A, section B and section C. Section A consists of 25 questions and we have to attempt only 20. Section B consists of 24 questions and we have to attempt any 20. Section C consists of 6 case study questions and we have to attempt only 5 out of 6. If you will attempt more than 20 questions, the first 20 will be considered. Maximum mark is 35 and the questions to be attempted is 45. The marks of each question will be 35 divided by 45 and approximately 0.77 marks will be there for each question. Now we'll discuss the questions. First question is, find the invalid identifier from the following. What is a Python identifier? Python identifier is a name given to an entity. It is user defined name. It can be variable, a function, a class or a module. Identifier is a combination of lowercase, uppercase, digits and an underscore. It cannot start with a digit. We cannot use special symbols. A keyword cannot be used in an identifier. None is a keyword, but the first letter should be capital. Here in first case, the none is in small letters. Second and third also satisfied the rules of identifier. The answer will be pass. The fourth option, we can check the answer in marking scheme. In second question, L is equal to 1, Python, 3.14 is written in round brackets. And as you know, square bracket is for list, round bracket is for tuple, and curly braces is for dictionary. The data type of L will be tuple as the datas are inside round brackets. In third question, TEP 1 is equal to 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. First, we will give the index for each element. It will start with 0 and ends with 8. Print TUP 1, 3, colon 7, colon 2. We will start with index 3 and will go up to index 6 because we know the upper limit will not be included. And colon 2 means it will first write 40, then it will skip 50 and it will write 60. The answer will be 40, 60 within round brackets. In fourth question, it is asking which of the following option is not correct. First option is, if we try to read a text file that does not exist, an error occurs and the error will be file not found. This statement is correct. Second one is, if we try to read a text file that does not exist, the file gets created. It is completely incorrect statement. Third and fourth options are true. Fourth question is, which of the following options can be used to read the first line of a text file, myfile.txt. Read function is used to read the complete file. Read n is used to read n number of bytes. Read lines is used to read all the lines. To read a single line, we should use read line. Third option is correct. You can check the fourth and fifth answer. In question 6, assume that the position of the file pointer is at the beginning of third line in a text file. Which of the following option can be used to read all remaining lines? To read lines, we should use myfile.readlines, which is used to read multiple lines. Read is used to read the complete file. Read n is used to read n number of bytes. We can check the answer in the marking scheme. Question 7 is, a text file student.txt is stored in the storage device. Identify the correct option out of the following options to open the file in read mode. In first option, RB is there and RB is used to read binary file. Double is used for writing in the file. R is used to open the file in read mode. If the mode is not given, then also it will open in read mode. The default mode is read mode. Options 3 and 4 will be correct and it is in C option. Question 8 is, the return type of input function is, answer will be option A, which is string. The input method reads the user's input and returns it as a string. You can check the answer. Question number 9 is, which of the following operator cannot be used with string data type? As we know, plus is concatenation operator, in is membership operator, star is replication operator. Plus is used to concatenate two strings. In operator will check if a character or a substring exists in the given string, and replication operator will replicate a string. Answer will be slash, which is option D. In question number 10, TUP1 is equal to 10, 15, 25, comma and 30. Here we have to identify the statement that will result an error. First we'll create the tuple. We know the elements of tuple are separated by comma and it will be enclosed by round brackets. The elements are 10, 15, 25 and 30. We will create the tuple in the Python IDLE and we will see the results. As per question, if we will write TUP1 is equal to within round brackets 10, 15, 25, and 30, it will give invalid syntax because the elements of tuples should be separated by commas only. Now we will create TUP1 is equal to within round brackets 10, 15, 25, 30. The index will start with 0 and will end with n minus 1. Here 4 elements are there. Then the index of 10 is 0 and 30 is 3. Print TUP1 2 will print the third element. Print min of TUP1 will print 10, the minimum element. Print length of tuple 1 will print 4 because there are 4 elements in the tuple. But we cannot assign new value to a tuple because tuple is immutable. The min method will return the element from the tuple having minimum value. We cannot change individual elements of a tuple. If we want to assign value to a tuple, type error, tuple object does not support item assignment error will come. But as you know, lists are mutable. If we will create one list and we want to change the element of a list, we can do it. Now, just to explain you, I am just creating one list with elements 20, 30 and 45. L1 to 56 means we are assigning a new value at index 2. Now we will print L1. You can see 56 is there at index 2. Here the answer will be second option. We can check the answer in the marking scheme. Question number 11 is, which of the following statement is incorrect in context of binary files? The first option is, information is stored in the same format in which information is held in memory. We all know binary files store data in binary form. No character translation takes place is the second option, which is correct because it is already in binary form. No translation is required. Third is, every line ends with a new line character, which is an incorrect statement. And fourth one is, Pickle module is used for reading and writing, which is absolutely correct. We have to import Pickle module to read and write in binary file. 12th question is, what is the significance of tell method? As we know, there are two file pointer location functions are there in Python, tell and seek. Tell function returns the current position of the file pointer, and seek function places the file pointer at the specified position. Option B will be correct. Tells the current position of the file pointer within the file. You can check the answer. 13th question is, which of the following statement is true? Pickling creates an object from a sequence of bytes. It will be a wrong option because Python object hierarchy is converted to byte stream in pickling. Second option is, pickling is used for object serialization, which is correct option. Third option is, pickling is used for object deserialization. This is on pickling, and pickling is used to manage all types of files. It is incorrect because pickling is used to manage only binary files. Here option B will be the answer. Now we'll check the marking scheme to see the correct answer. 14th question is, syntax of seek function in Python is myfile.seek offset comma reference point, where myfile is the file object. What is the default value of reference point? 0 is used for begin of the file, 1 is for current position of the file pointer, and 2 is for end of the file. By default, it will be placed from the beginning of the file. Answer will be 0, which is option 1. 15th question is, which of the following components are part of a function header in Python? Now we'll see one example. Def sum within bracket a comma b colon is the way to define a file header. As you can see, it is having a function name and parameter list. Option D, both A and C, is the correct answer. Now we can see the marking scheme. Hope the concept is clear to you. If you have any doubt, you can write in the comment section. Thanks for watching.